this is the United States. So the part that we're going to be focusing on is New England, which is this part in red over here. Mm-hmm. So whenever we reference New England or you hear that term, it's these specific states that it's referencing.
This is New Jersey.
Yeah, this is New Jersey. And then this is New York. So this is all kind of in the Northeast region. This is New England. New England, yeah. Can you go to the next one? And then this is a close-up of those states. So it's made up of Maine, New Hampshire, Vermont, Massachusetts, Rhode Island, and Connecticut. The biggest city in this entire area is Boston, which is what we're going to be talking about. I actually grew up in Boston, or around Boston, and Matt moved to Boston 3 years ago, 2 years ago, something like that, to move in with me. So New England is known for a couple of specific things. One of the first things is New England clam chowder, which is delicious. It's very specifically like from this region. Usually you can get the best clam chowder in Maine or in Boston, anywhere kind of right along the coast. There's also another type of clam chowder called, is it Manhattan or New York?
I don't know,
but it's from New York. And the difference is that they put tomatoes in it, so it makes it red. So there's actually a really odd law in Maine that if you cannot put tomatoes in clam chowder, it's illegal. You can't serve it in a restaurant.
It's illegal.
It's illegal. Yeah. I think you just get a fine or something, but it is like technically illegal to put tomatoes in clam chowder.
Yeah, that sounds illegal.
Yeah. Another thing this region is really known for is fall or autumn. The leaves on the trees turn like this really bright, like red and orange, and it's very kind of mountainous in this area, so people a lot of times in the United States specifically will vacation in New England during this time of year so that they can see all of this foliage. And this is Tom Brady. So we have a sports team in the U.S. It's a football team, American football, and it's the New England Patriots. The main quarterback or captain is Tom Brady, and everybody is obsessed with Tom Brady. People talk about Tom Brady like they know him, even though like no one's ever met him. Like, they'll call him Tom.
Tom.
Oh yeah, Tom. Did you hear what Tom said last week?
Yeah,
and everyone's like, yeah, I know. I get it.
People love this guy.
They worship him.
They worship him.
It's a huge thing. My dad loves Tom Brady. First time he met Matt, he was like, and this is Boston. Boston is actually, even though it's the biggest city in New England, it's actually a fairly small city. You can walk from one end to the other in like maybe 3 hours. It's not huge. It's also really nice to walk in Boston. There's a lot of really cool architecture, a lot of brick. It's a really pretty walk. But, yeah, it's not huge.
A lot of the surrounding areas are similar to areas like this outside of the top of the city. Mm-hmm. There are other little, smaller city
boroughs.
They're kind of called boroughs. Mm-hmm. And they're just smaller areas separated from the major downtown area of Boston, but still quite large, and that's where most people live, is actually outside of the city. And as you can see, there's a bunch of boats. It's on the water, so people love taking their boats out. And they're really expensive yachts.
These are probably tours. And this over here is the Charles River. It runs through Boston. Mm-hmm. And actually, we lived in a small town called Waltham. It was right outside of Boston, and we were right next to the river, so we used to go kayaking. So one of the specific things that Boston is really known for is this really specific accent. It's in a lot of movies. You've probably heard it and not known what it was. But we have like a video clip so you can hear what the accent sounds like. That clip, park the car in Harvard Yard. If someone wants to like imitate a Boston accent, you say park the car in Harvard Yard. Yeah. And then they drop all the R's and then they'll add R's in with weird places. So there's also a lot of Boston slang. So we're gonna do a little quiz to see if you can guess what these words mean. Yeah. So the packy. So, is it a pack of cigarettes, a liquor store, or the post office? So, vote with your hands. So, one for pack of cigarettes, two for a liquor store, three for
a post
office.
You have to give it a situation, right? Wait, in a sentence or something. Otherwise,
I'm heading down to the packy.
I reckon it's on the city.
Okay. Ready to hold up? It's a liquor store.
I've never heard anyone actually use that. But
really?
Yeah.
What? Yeah, Regina says it.
Ah, that's true.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah.
Yeah,
she does. And I have a friend from Thor.
Yeah.
So. It's like there. Not all of Boston has this accent. It's like this really specific, like southern part of Boston has this accent. So it's not everywhere. Like I grew up in Boston, but it just kind of depends. But it is really funny, and there's a lot of really great slang. So Boston is also really known for a lot of universities. You're gonna go. So sorry. So this one's Harvard, that I feel like you've probably heard of. That's the big one. This one's Boston University.
Yeah.
That's okay. That's MIT.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. MIT again.
Yeah.
I should have set it up like this. Northeastern. And Tufts. And those are all just in Boston.
Mm-hmm.
So Massachusetts in general is known for having a lot of really upscale colleges. It's kind of mostly because a lot of the country was founded around Boston and New York, so a lot of like the most educated people came to those areas. So that's kind of where they developed, so that's why they're still very collegiate and academic in these areas.
Yeah, there are, even just outside of these four major universities, there are dozens of other universities in and around Boston.
Mm-hmm.
Smaller schools, technical schools, just there. The city has so many universities and students, and that end up leaving school to then work back in research and different types of things in those, at the universities and schools.
Mm-hmm.
People in Boston.
Yeah.
So because of that, also,
oh.
You have a lot of engineers, so a lot of software development. It's very, very big in Boston right now. So in when you hear about anything about America, you hear about Silicon Valley, California, a lot of people do programming and where Facebook and Google and all these companies are. The other big area in the United States is Boston for technology. So that's kind of the second, the East Coast Silicon Valley is kind of what they call it sometimes. So very, very big for a lot of technology companies. Also, doctors and pretty much all medicine. Research.
Yeah. Tons of research.
Yeah, tons
because
of research,
Harvard,
yeah.
there's always medical studies going on. People a lot of times will travel to Boston from other places in the United States to get like the best care. Like the newest stuff a lot of times is developed in Boston.
Yeah, there's tons of hospitals, children's hospitals, cancer specialist hospitals, all kinds of different, every type of specialty, every type of, you know, sports medicine, everything like that is huge in around the city of Boston.
There's also a lot of marketing professionals and
true.
Business professionals.
Yeah.
That was just
so,
a funny picture.
That's funny, yeah.
But we both used to work in marketing in Boston.
So at technology companies, so like marketing technology companies, it's just it's,
huge.
Huge.
Yeah. There's
huge.
So many. And I think I speak for both of us when I say like we used to get emails all the time from other companies in Boston looking for talent and trying to get recruiting.
It's an endless pool of jobs, which sounds like a very not a bad problem to have, but there are a lot of jobs, but there are so many jobs just right in Boston. It's really crazy.
Yeah.
And bars and partying.
Yeah. Because there's so many young people, and because, like, there's so many, like, young professionals, like, there's a ton of nightlife in Boston, but it tends to be college students. So it's a little, like, messier, I would say. And, like, for us, we didn't enjoy it very much just because, like, we're a little bit older, and it'll make you feel old.
Yeah. There was a couple times my coworkers would want to take us out to the college bars. Didn't fit in. They were doing karaoke. It was all college students.
Yeah. So, another round of Boston Slang.
Yay.
That's a fun area.
Yeah.
That's a little bit.
Yeah. Pocketbook.
Pocketbook.
So, is it a small book?
I'll use it in a second.
A pocket watch or a purse?
I left my pocketbook in the house.
Exactly. It's
not helpful at all.
No. Can't give it away.
Well,
you're a vote. Wait.
I'm getting on the
floor.
Yeah.
No, three. You're right.
Three.
A
pocketbook. Pocketbook. It's not so important.
Yeah. A pocketbook. Oh, well, I mean, Boston is kind of fancy stuff.
Yeah, my name's Pocket. Pocketbook.
Why is it called a pocketbook?
That's a great question.
Pocketbook.
My
mom always called it a pocketbook as well. She's not from Boston, so I think it's an East Coast thing.
Yeah.
I
didn't even know it was slang.
I didn't either.
I thought it was
a pocketbook.
I thought it was a
pocketbook.
I was like, oh, people don't call it a pocketbook. The weather report. So what's the weather like in Boston? Snowy.
Wow. No.
There's
a lot
of snow.
This is, you can see as high as the bike.
More snow.
More snow. Yeah, so that's when they push this, when they plow the snow, the roads are so narrow. That people only, they don't driveways in Boston. There's no driveways around Boston. So people park their cars all these crazy places and the snow gets piled up really, really, really high.
Mm-hmm. One year they actually had to take like low torches.
Yeah, they had
to
melt
the snow because there was so much of it they couldn't get rid of it fast enough.
They had to move it
for it. Well, it's not. It's
supposed to be
here. It's not here. More snow.
This is kind of where a lot of the houses are in are outside the downtown area of Boston. They're row houses. So they have this house driveway. Well, not even always a driveway. House. And then inside these buildings, there's usually multiple apartments or even homes. But they look like regular old tons and tons of people that live in these, and they all park on the street, so it's a lot. This is almost every single year.
Yeah.
our house. But it doesn't snow all the time. Sometimes it's nice and nice. So, this is actually in Celsius, and I can't read it. So, this is for you.
I don't know. These are just some numbers.
These are just numbers to us.
Yeah.
So.
I think, 28's hot. I know that.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so peaking with 28, lowest is -5. Yeah. So,
it's quite miserable in January and February.
Yeah. And then, but sometimes it's nice out. This is the river that's by our house, or by our old house. And it goes all the way to Boston. We never went all the way from Boston to Boston.
No.
But you can go all the way.
Yeah.
But we used to walk through this and go back.
It's really, really nice.
So it's really expensive to live in Boston. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. What about? San Francisco, New York City, Boston, Hong Kong, Dubai. It's on the list of the top 5.
Yeah.
And when you see Hong Kong and Dubai in there, you know you're in trouble.
Yeah.
And it's above them.
Yeah. So. The first 3 are off of the US.
Yeah.
Not on the list?
Not on the list,
apparently. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Because it's probably one thing you can get, like, shared housing.
So yeah, this is just on average. It's very, very expensive to like actually live in Boston. So I wouldn't suggest living in Boston, but visiting Boston is really nice.
I had a couple of friends that wanted to buy apartments and homes, and it's very difficult to do because people will go with cash. They'll go with $100,000 in cash for a down payment in order to buy the property. So most people don't have a briefcase full of cash to go and buy a house with. So it's very difficult to buy a property. So a lot of people are forced to rent. And with prices like this, it's very difficult to live there.
Yeah.
So,
it's difficult to save up enough to buy a house because you're spending so much on rent. It is.
It's definitely. You can make a lot of money there. You can make a lot of money, but you're just broke. Yeah. It's very interesting. But if you have a good job, people really like it, but it's getting a little bit...
It's a little crazy.
It's a little crazy.
How did you guys make it?
Well, that's fine. We lived in a tiny apartment.
This little half of that.
Yeah, this little bit is our apartment. This is my car. Yeah. So yeah, it was a lot cheaper than the average. And it was outside of Boston, which is why it was a little bit cheaper. It was in
Waltham.
Yeah, so it's like 20 minutes outside of the city. Which is nice, actually, because we didn't actually work in Boston. We worked around it. But Cornette had to drive.
I had to drive.
To go to work, which is tough.
There's only maybe a handful of trains in Boston. And they don't go everywhere. They only really stay to the center of the city. They don't spread out outside. There's not really good infrastructure as there is here in Japan. So I have to drive every single day. And everybody drives. Lots of traffic. So, in order to go, what was it, 15 miles, that's kind of like 20 kilometers, maybe 25 kilometers, about an hour and 15 minutes every day.
Yeah.
It was tough.
Yeah. Boston slang! Donkeys or dunks. It's a brand of coffee shop. Dunkin' Donuts.
Oh, Dunkin' Donuts.
So there was a Dunkin' Donuts right here in my high school, so every day we were going to Dunks. So if you want to visit Boston or Massachusetts, here's a list of things that you should see. Next. This is Faneuil Hall. It's kind of like I don't know what it used to be. I think it used to be like a meeting house back in the day. But now it's like a market. A lot of times they'll have festivals here, street performances, There's lots of food, lots of bars in this area. It's also really pretty. See this, like, these brick buildings, they're all over Boston. They're kind of, like, peppered in throughout, like, the big, tall buildings. So this is, like, you go from the financial district to things like this. So this is the Freedom Trail. So I didn't want to kind of make this boring and go into all the history that happened in Boston, because there's a lot. But if you wanted to learn about the history that happened in Boston, this is a really great way to do it. This trail is called the Freedom Trail. It's a walking trail through Boston. You can either pay and do it with a tour guide, or you can do it on your own. There are a lot of different historical sites to stop at, and they're all marked with these big medallions in the street. But there's things like the site of the Boston Massacre, the State House, Benjamin Franklin statue.
A lot of old American things.
Yeah,
if,
old
if
war monuments.
If you've seen anything in history like books about early America, this would be a lot of things. Yeah. The duck boat.
The duck boat.
So the duck boats are pretty much exclusive to Boston, and what they are is they are old World War II style vehicles that were used for the for land and water, and they were called DUCK, D-U-K, for some sort of acronym for
something. Yeah.
And what they did was they remade them as replicas, and they do tours in them.
Yeah.
So they drive around the city, and they do different like speaking tours, and they sightseeing, and then they go in the water.
Yeah. And they're really
fun. It's
a funny moment. And you take a boat tour at the same time, all in the same vehicle.
And sometimes they'll let you drive it too.
Yeah. It's very Boston. It's only in Boston.
So this is the MFA, which is the Museum of Fine Arts. It's a really fun way to spend the day. There's tons of different statues and paintings and all sorts of stuff. And actually, the last time I went,
we went to the sorry.
It sure
is.
Oh,
wait, we went there.
Yeah.
So,
like recognizing it.
This is the science museum. They have all kinds of different stuff. They have dinosaurs. They have planes, like aviation, as well as different types of things you can play with and interact with for science experiments. It's a lot of fun for children.
Mm-hmm.
I think we enjoy it as adults, but it's definitely really fun for kids. They can go and learn and do all that kind of stuff. There's never something or other.
Yeah, it's like a Tesla coil.
Yeah.
So they have this really big show that's really cool that they'll like actually like create lightning in the room.
That's cool.
Yeah, and they like, you know, explain all of it and have lots of like audience participation. But it's all kind of set up for kids. Every like exhibit is set up so that you can like touch and play and mess with it. So it's pretty fun. It's very interactive.
This is, we have an aquarium in Boston.
Yeah.
It's like maybe a Wall Street. Yeah. Some famous food here in Boston is the Boston Cream Donut, which you can get at most kinds of donuts.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. I mean, they won't have that at Mr. Donut.
They will not
they
have that at Mr. Donut.
Yeah.
They're really good. There's also a Boston Cream Pie that you can get.
Yeah. It looks very similar, but that's the donut. Lobster rolls, which are New England. They're lobster in a roll. Very, very, very good. You can only really get them
on the
East Coast. Yeah. And then Boston also is famous for Samuel Adams beer, which I don't think that they import into Japan. But in addition to that, Boston and Massachusetts are very famous for craft beer. So There's a lot of craft beer, the darker beers in Massachusetts. There's tons and tons of breweries. So a lot of people in Boston drink beer. Like whenever you go to a bar, there's 30 or 40 different types of beers.
A lot of people homebrew
when they
get on beer. Yeah. This is also a really fun thing to do. In
Boston or in the area to go to one of these sporting events. Sports are huge in Boston. People are really like diehard fans. So going to like the events are really, really fun. So our boy Tom Brady again. This guy, so we actually nicknamed him Dice K, but he's Japanese. Yeah. So that's the Boston Red Sox. There is the Boston Celtics and the Bruins.
Yeah, Boston is has in every sport has one of the most famous teams in the United States. So similar to New York.
Yeah.
Every single team people love it. So.
Yeah.
Boston
play.
Wicked pissed up. Next one, and don't go to the
Okay.
Does it mean awesome? That's unfortunate. Or very drunk.
Kind of means everything.
People use it like manji, I guess. Like it's one of those things that just. You kind of say it with everything, and it really just depends on what you're talking about. So it can mean a good thing, it can mean a bad thing, it can mean you're inappropriate, it can mean you're awesome. It really just depends on how you use
yeah,
it.
Yeah, it's really can mean many different things.
Yeah.
Another fun thing in Boston is PAX. It's a very big video game convention, similar to the Tokyo Game Show. This is the biggest one in the United States, and about almost 100,000 people attend every year. So this is also this is where Michelle and I actually met at PAX at the gaming convention, and then we went back the following year and we took this picture. There's me there doing an interview. They have all kinds of different video game vendors go, board games, people play board games. Go there to show off their games and things like that. That's what I used to do there. Like, just go hang out and walk around.
Yeah, every
year. Yeah, we've been every year. This is the first year I've missed in the past.
Yeah. So that's kind of an overview of Boston.
So, how far from the New York downtown?
New York? It's
Manhattan.
From Manhattan to Boston is 4 hours.
4 hours by train or bus?
By train, bus, or by car. It's the same amount of time.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
4 hours.
Yeah.
Same time by train?
Yeah.
The trains are not good.
A little bit, maybe 3.5 hours, but I'm going to say four. Yes. Yeah, it's pretty
good. Because, like, I'm just thinking about Japanese standard, it would be completely different. Right?
Yeah, you can give up the whole country on Shinkansen for 3.5 hours. It's the problem is that there's only one train line that goes from, I think it actually goes from Boston down to Washington, D.C. No, all of it goes.
Maybe want to go back to that. Yeah. It's all up over here.
So it goes from Boston here, down to Washington, D.C., which is like here.
Mm-hmm.
So that is one train.
One train?
Yep.
One line?
There's one train with, there's one line. Mm-hmm. I think it only honestly maybe has like a couple different deviations from this,
mm-hmm.
and it stops in a couple different places here, and then that's it. There are other train systems, but there's no train system this way.
I think a train went from Boston down to Florida.
Yeah,
not Florida.
It took me a day and a half.
Day and a half.
Yeah,
flying.
Yeah,
it's much better. Also very expensive.
Yeah.
So.
And you can drive from Manhattan to Boston for cheaper and the same thing. I lived in Delaware.
Get over here.
Mm-hmm. Oh yeah, right here. And I drove all the way up.
So we met in Boston for PAX, but then we lived in Delaware.
Delaware. So, but we were working together and eventually started the meeting. It was a really long ride.
So it was like long distance relationship.
Yeah.
We went from long distance to living together.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Fresh.
This doesn't like fresh one. Like it's different.
Raw
fish. Right. What do you mean?
Like fresh. Like seafood.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Fresh.
Graphical. Oh, not raw. Okay. Yes, very fresh.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, there are some.
There's really good seafood in this area because it's fresh.
Yeah.
You can get seafood in other parts of the U.S., but obviously, like, if you're over in this area, like,
mm-hmm.
you can't have fresh.
Mm-hmm.
Whereas if you're over in this area,
A lot of what people eat on the coast here is fish, but it's not as much fish. Americans just don't eat a ton of fish.
Yeah.
What they do eat is a lot of crab, lobster, shrimp,
a lot of shellfish,
oysters, clams, that kind of stuff. So while they do catch a lot of stuff out here in the bay, it's not necessarily just for local area. The real demand is shellfish, but I would imagine some of the local source.
Yeah. There's also like a lot of good fishing if you're in Massachusetts. This little hook is called the Cape Cod. So a lot of people will vacation on the Cape, but there's lots of fishing and beaches, and it's also very historic. But it's funny because all of Massachusetts goes to the Cape to go to vacation, all of them. So, and there's one bridge to get to the Cape.
Yeah, one bridge.
So to get to the Cape sucks. Not worth it.
It's really cool there, but yeah, it's the entire state, which looks very small here, but in the grand scheme of things,
this is probably like a 2 to 3 hour drive. So that, like, just to get to the end of the Cape takes a long time. And there's tons of traffic. There's one road. Like, once you go over the one bridge, there's one road. Everybody's in a straight line to get to the end of the Cape.
Yeah.
It's terrible.
It's crazy.
Yeah. Yeah, it is really crazy. But there's lots of difference.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I have two questions. So, in my hometown, my father has a lot of smaller and people die.
Well, it's different. What do they die from?
Is it being cold?
No.
From the roof.
Oh. Say they cannot see the roof. That's why. Like, you start dropping into the hole or something.
Oh, yeah.
We have been, like, every year someone gets run over by a plow. That happens every year.
Yeah, the plow, I think, is kind of a crazy, but car accidents. Because everybody, again, you only drive. Everybody has a car. At least one car, if not two, per household. So people get into bad accidents while driving, I would say, is mostly the case.
For the most part.
That depends.
Yeah.
It depends where you work. A lot of places in the city of Boston will just either close and just say work from home. They close pretty. If it's ice at all, go for
it. It has to be pretty bad. A lot of people are used to driving in it, so they assume that because you live in this area, you know how to drive on icy roads. So it has to be pretty icy.
When I lived down here, right here in Mississippi, it snowed about a half an inch, and the entire town closed down for 4 days. No school, no restaurants, no grocery stores.
Yeah.
People wouldn't leave the house.
They were terrified.
Terrified.
Whoa.
Yeah.
It doesn't snow there.
It doesn't snow here. But that was funny.
Yeah, many university students
who
come to So most of students cannot live alone because it's expensive.
Or they'll live in dorms. So a lot of, like, housing has been in dorms and colleges.
Yeah. When if you don't live in the dorm, like when you're a little older, people live in with roommates.
Yeah.
A lot of
people that I work with at my job or around my age would live with 5 or 6 roommates before their rent because it's so expensive.
It's almost everybody actually.
Yeah.
Everybody, Michelle and I were kind of a rare.
Yeah. I got that apartment by myself.
Yeah. It was a one bedroom apartment to live in, but most university students, if they're not in a dorm, they are living with probably 4 or 5 different people. One of my coworkers lived with 7 different people in a house.
Yeah. And the houses are also not super nice. A lot of them are very old and not taken care of very well. So things are often broken, falling apart. Very nice. It's still that expensive, which is kind of like the shame of it that you are paying so much and it's not. Even
yeah, it's really it's you go because the schools are very good, so it's worth it. And a lot of people do like the area because it's fun and there's a lot of things to do. So they think it's worth it.
We don't.
Yeah.
Yeah,
it's
really
nice.
Do you want to go to Boston?
Yes, I do.
Yay!
Do you have any questions for them? Like, anything about the time?
Well,
I mean, I was trying
to get it. I have so many, but usually I just ask them what they think of them.
Yeah. So, it looks like I have the same duck bus you have.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, yeah.
You have a duck bus in Osaka?
Yeah.
I saw
it. On the land to the water.
Okay. Is it called the duck boat? What is it called?
I don't know.
I think they definitely have them. Yeah, that's I know the duck boat is they have the whole brand. There's like the logo is a duck and everything. It's
actually a story that goes with it too about ducklings walking through a school. It's like a children's book. But there's statues of these little ducks that are at like one of the ponds that the duck boat goes through. So they always talk about the story.
When they come, I always
so
ask
many.
Me.
Yeah. I never wait.
I think I got.
Someone.
We got pizza, and I think I had all my questions for you. What was the spice?
Yeah, we got so many things.
What was the spice in it?
Wasabi?
No, it's a little chili mixture.
You have two kinds of.
There's two kinds, yeah.
So just one, then seven.
Yeah.
Seven taste or one taste. So one is the more hot dog.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What do you guys think about the situation in America?
Glad we're not there.
Just America as a situation.
As a situation.
Yeah.
The situation. I'm embarrassed by our president.
I think I'm happy not to be there right now because everybody is not happy in America. You can feel that there's a lot of stress.
Everyone's uncomfortable.
Yeah, everybody is very stressed.
Yeah.
And you can kind of feel it.
Same as old.
Could be the same here. I just don't know. We don't have rockets flying over the country, so we don't have that yet, but maybe when we live here. So,
I do feel like people are quite stressed. In the UK, especially, like after Brexit.
There was a little bit of tension, but it's just a waiting game. But it was just a bit awkward for me to go into work when most of my friends are Europeans.
I think there's a lot of that going around all over the world. The biggest stress that I think in America right now is just like a lot of the violence. So
and the mental health.
Yeah, there's just like a lot of things that just happen all the time, and it's, the problem is America is so big that when you hear about something, it seems like it's next door, even though it's really not. It's you can't get that out of your mind.
Definitely a weird day when Trump was elected. Like going into work the next day was very weird.
Yeah, it was very strange.
It was very like eerie. It was really like uncomfortable. Mm. And I remember sitting at lunch with all of my coworkers, and it was just silent.
Mm.
And we're all just eating like, oh my God, what does this mean? Like, what
you're dreaming?
What message did we just send the rest of the world?
Yeah.
Very uncomfortable and scared and yeah. I don't think that feeling has really left. Yeah. But it's also shocking because he made it into office, so it really means that a lot of Americans aren't in touch with each other. They don't not understanding each other. And I think there's a big sense of that, especially when you look at social media. A lot of people are yelling and saying opposite things and not understanding each other. No one's really listening. Everyone's just really freaked out.
A lot of opinions in America. And everybody wants to voice them. And it's a very good thing, I think, when people are voicing their opinions. But when you come from certain places like we've come from, which are very open and diverse, there's a lot of different types of people in where we've grown up and things like that. Other parts of the country aren't as fortunate. So they have a completely different view than we do. So it's not really one America, it's many different things. It's many different Americas, which is what's very difficult being an American, because my opinion and the way I see the world is very different than someone who lives
in Mississippi.
Mississippi or Texas or California or anywhere else. So the way I see the world is, just because I'm from America, I probably see the world in a completely different way as some of those people. That polar opposite way. So I think it's hard to relate to people even when it's like, oh, from America.
Yeah.
That means
you're supposed to be the same, but really it feels more like your neighbors.
I was going to ask is like, because Japan, the culture in Japan